Watching Take Two.
We've been monitoring the ongoing eruption at Kilauea since December 23rd of 2024 last year. The last episode from this past Sunday brought on spectacular views. So with more details, we've got Katie Mulliken, a geologist with Hawaiian Volcano Observatory, joining us this morning. Aloha, Katie. Thanks again for coming on this morning.
Hey, thank you so much for having me.
So a ton of fun questions. You know, why was this last episode, episode 23 of this eruption, just so spectacular?
Yeah, so the USGS Hawaiian Volcano Observatory has been monitoring this eruption now for 5 months. It hasn't been erupting continuously, though. It's erupted in these episodes. And the 23rd episode happened this past Sunday. It was about 6 hours long. And it was really interesting because we've seen for the past recent episodes that either the north vent or the south vent have been active. And in episode 23, both were erupting simultaneously. So that was really interesting. And then on top of that, we had the highest lava fountains recorded so far in this eruption. Lava fountains during episode 23 reached just under 1,200 feet around 5:30 p.m. So just an hour or so after the episode began.
Wonderful. And we've got some amazing time-lapse videos here. So of course, thank you to the USGS for that. You know, speaking of the previous episodes, because like you were saying, they're episodes, they're not one full eruption. So were any previous episodes before this 23rd eruption at Kilauea that produced this fountain, were any of the other ones like the magnitude that we saw from the north and also south vent?
Yeah, we've had a handful of the previous episodes reach about 1,000 feet elevation, so kind of close to what episode 23 reached, but 23 surpassed that just a little bit. And then in Kilauea's history, if you look further back, the highest lava fountain ever recorded at Kilauea was in 1959, and that eruption reached 1,900 feet elevation. And then worldwide, if you look at volcanoes in other places, eruptions in Japan and Italy have reached up to 3,000 to 5,000 feet elevation lava fountains. So really varies depending on the volcano and the chemistry and the vent dynamics.
Wow. Okay. So speaking of that, before this eruption from December 23rd onward, were there any previous ones that were monitored similarly? Anything that was as spectacular as what we've been seeing currently?
Yeah, episodic eruptions have occurred just a few times in Kilauea's past, over the past couple hundred years. In 1959, I mentioned the Kilauea Iki eruption. There were 17 episodes of that eruption over about a month, so much more frequent episodes in a shorter eruption overall. And then in 1969, the Mauna Ulu eruption on the East Rift Zone, there were 12 episodes in that eruption, but over several months. So those were more spaced out lava fountains. And then most recently, the Pu'uo'o eruption in 1983, when that eruption was getting started, there were 44 lava fountains over a period of about 3 years. So those were happening more on kind of a monthly time scale. And then in terms of heights, all three of those eruptions produced lava fountains higher than what we're seeing now at Kilauea. Those were in the range of 1,500, 1,700, and 1,900 feet. So although this eruption, we've surpassed two of the past eruptions in terms of the number of episodes. So we have now more than Kilauea Iki and more than Mauna Ulu, but we've only got about half the number of episodes of the Pu'uo'o eruption, but we haven't passed any of them in terms of the fountain heights.
Okay, this is so fascinating. So if viewers want the possibility to be able to go to the Big Island and see this in the future, is there any tips, any tricks that you could give when we visit Hawaiian Volcano Observatory?
Yes, so the repeating nature of this eruption is really interesting, and it allows the Hawaiian Volcano Observatory to make some kind of forecasts of when the next episode could occur. Of course, the activity on the volcano is dynamic and it's always changing, so our forecasts sometimes are adjusted. But we publish those in our Kilauea Daily Updates. So those are published every day by noon. And you can find those on our website, or you can subscribe to them at USGS Volcano Notification Service. So if you Google USGS VNS, you can subscribe to receive those via email. And we'll publish the forecast daily. And then we also publish a separate notice when a fountaining episode is going to start and when it ends. So good to subscribe to those if you're interested in catching the activity. We also have three live stream cameras at the summit of Kilauea. So if you're curious about the activity yourself, you can check those. And we have a wealth of information on our website. So really a lot of frequent updates in between those official emailed ones. All of that's available on our website.
Sounds amazing. Thank you so much, Katie, for joining us this morning. And of course, we'll have this interview on k22.com for the viewers if they want to rewatch it. Thanks again for joining us. Have a good Aloha Thursday, Katie.
Thank you.